Hello my dear students, welcome to my class. In the previous video we have studied about the epithelial tissue. Now let us discuss about the second part of the animal tissues. In this part we will study about the connective tissue. Connective tissues are the most widely distributed tissues in the body of complex animals. Due to its special functioning of linking and supporting the various parts of body, it has been named as the connective tissue. See, connective tissues, these are widely distributed tissues in the body of the complex animals. Now why these are known as the connective tissues? Because they are helpful in linking and supporting the various parts of the body. That's why it is named as the connective tissue. The connective tissue has three main components. These components are cells, fibers and ground substance. So these are the three main components of the connective tissue: cells, fibers and ground substance. Here you can see the classification of the connective tissue. The connective tissues are classified into three types. These three types are loose connective tissue, dense connective tissue and specialized connective tissue. The loose connective tissue are further classified into areolar and adipose tissue. Dense tissue are classified into dense regular connective tissue and dense irregular connective tissues. Dense regular connective tissues are further classified into white fibrous connective tissue, which includes cord and sheath, cord that is tendon, yellow elastic connective tissue, it also consists of ligament and sheath. Then specialized connective tissue, these are classified into skeletal tissue, vascular tissue, pigmented connective tissue. Skeletal tissue are classified into cartilage and bone, bone into two types, compact and spongy, cartilage into three types, hyaline cartilage, fibrous cartilage and calcified cartilage. So these are the various kinds of the connective tissues. Now let us discuss about the each type one by one. Let us start. Here you can see the different types of the connective tissue according to their location. See, fat droplets. So these are the adipose tissues. It is also a type of connective tissue. From first, loose connective tissue. These loose connective tissues are found under the skin. See, their main components are cell, collagen fibers, elastic fibers, etc. See, these are present under the skin. See, here you can see the section of the arm showing various kinds of the connective tissue. So, first, on the upper layer, we can see the loose connective tissue which are found under the skin. Then, you can see the fibrous connective tissue. See here. So, here you can see the enlarged structure. This fibrous connective tissue, they form the tendon. They consist of cell nucleus as well as collagen fibers. Then see, after that you can see here adipose tissue or fat tissues. They consist of the fat droplets. Then here the bones, which called as cartilage tissue. It is found at the end of the bone. So it is a cartilage tissue. Then here you can see the bone tissue. Then inside you can see blood. Means these are the various kinds of the connective tissue found in the body of an individual. The loose connective tissue. The cells and fibers of loose connective tissues are loosely arranged in a semi-fluid ground substance. There are two types of the loose connective tissue. These two types are areolar and adipose connective tissue. The first type of the connective tissue is areolar connective tissue. This connective tissue contains all the cells and fibers in a thin, almost fluid-like ground substance. Areolar connective tissue is the simplest and most widely distributed connective tissue. Here you can see the structure of the areolar connective tissue. It is the simplest and most widely spread form of the connective tissue. Location. The areolar connective tissue is found between the skin and muscles. It is also found around the blood vessels, nerves, and other organs of the body. What would be the functions of loose connective tissue? It's very important type of connective tissue. It behaves as a supporting and packing tissue between the various organs lying in the body cavity. It cements the skin with underlying muscles. It helps in the repair of injured tissues after an injury. See, areolar connective tissue. Very important type of the connective tissue, where it is found between the skin and muscles. Its functions are, it is supporting. See, it supports our skin. It is also a packing tissue between the various organs. ऑर्गन्स के बीच में जो कैविटी होती है तो उसके बीच में ये एरियोलर कनेक्टिव टिश्यू होता है. इट ऑल्सो हेल्प टू सीमेंट द स्किन विथ अंडरलाइंग मसल्स. मीन्स स्किन और उसके अंदर जो मसल्स है उसको अटैच करने का काम एरियोलर कनेक्टिव टिश्यू करता है. अगर हमें कोई इंजुरी होती है, कोई जख्म वगैरह होता है, तो उसको भी ठीक करने का काम ये एरियोलर कनेक्टिव टिश्यू ही करता है. मीन्स इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टाइप ऑफ ए कनेक्टिव टिश्यू. नेक्स्ट, adipose connective tissue. Adipose connective tissues are specialized for the storage of fats. See, this diagram is very important for 3 marks. Draw the neat and labeled diagram of the adipose tissue. Adipose tissue is another type of loose fibrous connective tissue packed with adipocytes that are specialized for storage of fats. Hamare skin ke andar जो फैट स्टोर होता है, वो फैट स्टोर करने का काम कौन सा टिश्यू करता है? एडिपोज टिश्यू. एडिपोज टिश्यू और द फैट टिश्यू. हियर यू कैन सी द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द एडिपोसाइट. सी हियर यू कैन सी द एडिपोज सेल. सी हियर इज द एम्प्टी एडिपोज सेल एंड दिस इज द एडिपोज सेल विच इज फिल्ड विद द फैट. ईच एडिपोसाइट इज फिल्ड विद सिंगल लार्ज ड्रॉपलेट ऑफ फैट एंड ऑक्यूपाइज मोस्ट ऑफ द वॉल्यूम ऑफ द सेल. So its cytoplasm, nucleus and other components are pushed towards the periphery of the cell. See here you can see its nucleus and cytoplasm are pushed towards the periphery of the cell. अगर आप ठीक से स्ट्रक्चर देखोगे तो आपको पता चलेगा कि ये जो सारे सेल्स है इनके बीच में क्या है, देर इज ए वैक्यूल एंड इट इज फिल्ड विद द लार्ज ड्रॉपलेट ऑफ द फैट. हियर यू कैन सी द ड्रॉपलेट ऑफ द फैट. So just because of that large droplet of the fat, its nucleus as well as cytoplasm, it is pushed towards the periphery. मतलब इसका जो nucleus और cytoplasm होता है, cell के एक side को push हो जाता है. Why? Because of the large size of the fat droplet. See its location. The adipose tissue is found below the skin, between the internal organs as well as in the bone marrow. The adipose tissue acts as the insulating layer to reduce the heat loss through the skin. See, this adipose tissue also plays very important role in our body. It acts as the insulating layer. Adipose tissue ki wajah se hamari body se extra heat loss nahi hota hai. It also serves as a reservoir for fats. That means jo adipose tissue hota hai hamare body mein, wo fats ko store karta hai. It also performs certain functions like keeping the visceral organs in position and forming the shock absorbing cushions around some major organs like kidneys and eyeballs. ये इसका बहुत important function है. Visceral organs मतलब हमारे body के अंदर के जो important organs है उनको अपनी position पे रखता है adipose tissue. Shock absorber का भी काम करता है. आपको पता है vehicles में भी, टू व्हीलर्स में भी shock absorbers होते हैं, तो उनकी वजह से हमें shock नहीं लगता है. उसी तरह से ये जो adipose tissue है, ये cushion like structure तैयार करते हैं हमारे जो important organs है, जैसे kidneys, eyeball, etc. तो उसकी वजह से अगर हम गिरते हैं, कोई injury होती है, तो भी उसका shock हमारे internal organs तक नहीं पहुंचता है. उसकी वजह से हमें ज्यादा problems नहीं होते. This adipocyte is also very important tissue of our body. Next type is dense connective tissue. It consists of predominantly of fibers which are compactly packed. अभी आप dense connective tissue का अगर structure देखोगे इसमें मेनली क्या होते हैं, फाइबर्स होते हैं और कॉम्पैक्टली पैक, मतलब एकदम एक दूसरे के नजदीकी पैक किए होते हैं। देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ द डेंस कनेक्टिव टिश्यू, दिस टू टाइप्स आर टेंडॉन्स एंड लिगामेंट्स। टेंडॉन इट इज ए फाइबरस टिश्यू इन विच द फाइबर ऑकर्स इन थिक पैरेलल बंडल्स। टेंडॉन, टेंडॉन किस टाइप का कनेक्टिव टिश्यू, इट इज ए फाइबरस टिश्यू, मीन्स इट इज फाइबर लाइक टिश्यू एंड फाइबर्स ऑकर इन द थिक पैरेलल बंडल्स। दिस टिश्यूज हैव ग्रेट स्ट्रेंथ बट देयर फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी इज रेस्ट्रिक्टेड, बहुत पावरफुल होते हैं लेकिन ज्यादा फ्लेक्सिबल नहीं होते। इट इज ए थिक बैंड विच बाइंड्स ए मसल विथ मूवेबल स्ट्रक्चर सच एज बोन। इट इज इम्पोर्टेंट, टेंडॉन्स किसको ज्वाइन करते हैं, देखो टेंडॉन्स बाइंड ए मसल विथ बोन, इट इज इम्पोर्टेंट, टेंडॉन्स मसल और बोन्स को ज्वाइन करते हैं। नेक्स्ट टाइप इज लिगामेंट्स। लिगामेंट इज ए शॉर्ट बैंड ऑफ टफ फाइबरस टिश्यू। अभी हमने देखा कि जो टेंडॉन्स इट इज ए लॉन्गर बैंड, लिगामेंट इट इज ए शॉर्ट बैंड ऑफ द टफ फाइबरस टिश्यूज। इट इज हाईली इलास्टिक एंड इट हैज ए ग्रेट स्ट्रेंथ। लिगामेंट्स में इलास्टिसिटी ज्यादा होती है और वो ज्यादा स्ट्रेंथ होती है। दिस स्ट्रॉन्ग इलास्टिक बैंड्स होल्ड द बोन्स टुगेदर इन प्रॉपर आर्टिकुलेशन एट द जॉइंट्स एंड सपोर्ट्स द इंटरनल ऑर्गन्स। सी, लिगामेंट्स हेल्प इन कनेक्टिंग बोन्स टू बोन्स। अभी हमने देखा कि टेंडॉन्स क्या करते हैं, टेंडॉन कनेक्ट मसल्स टू द बोन्स व्हाइल लिगामेंट्स कनेक्ट बोन्स टू द बोन्स। सो दीज आर स्ट्रॉन्ग इलास्टिक बैंड्स। द डैमेज टू वन और मोर लिगामेंट्स इन ए जॉइंट कॉज्ड बाय ट्रॉमा और द जॉइंट बीइंग टेकन बियॉन्ड इट्स फंक्शनल रेंज ऑफ मोशन, इट रिजल्ट्स इन टॉर्न लिगामेंट, दैट कंडीशन इज नोन एज द स्प्रेन। अगर किसी वजह से, किसी एक्सीडेंट की वजह से अगर कोई लिगामेंट डैमेज होता है तो उसको हम क्या कहते हैं, उस कंडीशन को, दैट कंडीशन इज कॉल्ड एज स्प्रेन। हियर यू कैन सी द पोजिशन ऑफ लिगामेंट्स एंड टेंडॉन्स। सी लिगामेंट्स दे कनेक्ट बोन्स टू बोन्स व्हाइल द टेंडॉन्स दे कनेक्ट मसल्स टू द बोन्स। हियर इज ए कंपेरिजन इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर 3 marks। Compare between ligaments and tendons. See, the tendons join skeletal muscles to a bone. Ligaments join a bone to another bone. Tendon is tough and inelastic. Ligament, it is strong but it is elastic. It is a major difference. Tendon is inelastic while ligament is elastic. It is a modification of the white fibrous tissue. Ligament, it is a modification of yellow elastic tissue with some collagen fibers. Its fibroblast lies in a almost continuous rows. इसमें जो thread like structure होते हैं, these are seen in the continuous rows. While in case of ligaments, the thread like structures they lie scattered. एक जगह एक साथ continuous structure नहीं होता है, scattered मतलब ये फैले हुए या बिखरे हुए होते हैं. Its fibers are seen as the dense parallel bundles. The fibers are ligaments are densely crowded but these are not arranged in the parallel bundles. See, jo tendon ke fibers hote hai wo kaise dikhte hai, parallel lines ke structure mein dikhte hai, aur ligaments ke jo fibers hote hai these are crowded, they are not arranged parallelly. See, fibroblast, it is the most common type of cell found in the connective tissue. The fibroblasts secrete collagen proteins that are used to maintain the structural framework for many tissues. They also play an important role in healing of the wounds. Means these fibroblasts are very important types of the connective tissues. Here you can see the fibroblasts found in the various areas of the face. They play important role in healing of the wounds. In next video, we will study about the another special connective tissue known as blood. Thank you.